post-Gaddafi Libya, a new temporary government for the first time, and it met today. Joining me again tonight, someone with unprecedented access to the emerging leadership, Mansour El-Khikhia, is an exiled Libyan opposition leader who hails from a powerful political family. He's also a professor of political science at the University of Texas at San Antonio. Professor, thank you for coming back.
Thank you for having me.
So last night you told us that there had been a provisional government formed,
yes,
and in fact we're now beginning to see articles in the paper about it. Tell us who they are, who leads it, what power they've got.
I have two people actually leading it. First of all is a man, gentleman, is judged by the name of Mustafa Abdel Jalil, and the assistant is an individual by Abdullah Abdel Fattah Abdel Hafiz Doga. They were supposed to be on your show today, but they could not be. They will be tomorrow, I hope.
We hope
they will be. Actually, it's made up of 30 individuals from the liberated areas of Libya, and it will increase even more. They really have four more important tasks to do. The first is to take care of the individuals who are in the areas that have been liberated. The second, and even more important, is to ensure the safety of, at least coordinate about how to liberate the rest of Libya out of Gaddafi's control. The third one is to watch the military, the new military government, that the military forces that are being formed to deal with Gaddafi. They don't want a separate entity by itself. They want civilian rule to oversee the military, which is, I think, is very important. And of course, even more important is the finding the food and the creation of a new system.
Who gives them legitimacy? The 30 individuals, you say, from 30 different regions, are those cities, towns that have been liberated? Who chose these 30 individuals?
Each one of those cities sent a representative of that government.
And do they have the recognition of the mass of the population in Benghazi, for instance?
The Benghazi has its own representative in there. Sabrata has its own representative in there. The Zawi has own representative. Even the Amazigh of Western Libya have their own representative in there. And it increases as each part is being liberated, they have a representative in there. And they make up these committees to ensure the creation of a new government which will actually prepare for elections and prepare for on the constitution.
So this is the organic growth of democracy within Libya.
Exactly, exactly.
Now, you mentioned something critically important. They control the military. Is the opposition military something that is structured enough to report back to this provisional government?
They're trying to ensure that it is. It's always very difficult, Elliot. The problem over here is this is the new experiment for Libya, for so many of them who have never grown up within a military, within a civilian.
For instance, today in El Braga, there was some back and forth. Gaddafi sent in his forces. They took over briefly, we are told, and then they were repulsed. Who was in charge of that at a military level for the opposition?
Actually, the group within Benghazi who actually gave the orders, this is why they couldn't come on your show. They actually sent reinforcement to El Brega, and they pushed back El Gaddafi to the outskirts of the country, and they followed, they pursued them.
Does the military recognize this provisional government as the voice for the new Libya?
This is the wonder. Yes, they do. And they recognize this military, this new government as being the legitimate government of new Libya that will lead to a democratic system in the country.
Look, there's so many issues here to pursue, but I want to come back to the military standoff that we appear to be seeing created right now. What is it that the Libyan opposition needs the West to do, or Europe or the world to do, or not to do? Do you want the no-fly zone, for instance?
We want to ground Gaddafi, level the playing field. You ground Gaddafi, we will beat him. He's bringing in mercenaries, even till today. Just 2 hours before coming over here, I had contacts with people down the south in Sabha. He's bringing Malians, Tuareg from Mali. He's bringing about 400 mercenaries from Chad. And they're all going to come to Tripoli. We can deal with them as long as we have something to stop those airplanes from bombing.
So when you say ground Gaddafi, what you mean is ground his air force?
Ground his air force.
How do you want the West or NATO or the Arab League to do that? Whose voice do you want to be heard?
I don't trust the Arab League. The Arab League is an airbag. There's no hope.
But let me play devil's advocate for a minute. If the United States suddenly announced we were going to go in and establish a no-fly zone, suddenly it would look as though the opposition, the revolution, was driven by the West, and isn't that not what Gaddafi is arguing? We don't want to reinforce that argument, so somebody needs to invite us in.
I understand the provisional government is willing to consider dealing with the Europeans and the United States as long as they create a no-fly zone, but not initial American troops or European troops on Libyan soil. Okay.
So no intervention, but a no-fly zone.
But no no-fly zone.
Has there been any contact that you're aware of between this provisional government and the two leaders in particular and United States diplomats or NATO or anybody else in Europe?
Actually, very little indeed.
Very little.
Very little. And it's about time there should be something done. I mean,
do they need an ambassador here in the United States?
Yes, they do. Of course they do. And this is my advice to them. In fact, today I said, you've got to appoint someone to talk with the United States. Don't just say, go there.
Is this you? Are you sending your resume? Are you the person?
No, no, they choose. I don't. I'm outside here. I mean,
they have diplomats here. There are diplomats at the UN who've resigned. Yes, why don't they designate somebody to begin this process?
And that is exactly my point. But what you make is very valid. Yes, there are people who are here competent. Designate them. Let them deal with the central, with the governments. And that way, at least, you get the support.
All right.
Have to fight.
Right. Okay. To be continued. All right. Mansour El-Kikia, again, a fascinating perspective. Thank you for stopping by. Coming